The world was shaken by the news that new drugs are now available to help us lose weight. In this video, I will discuss Ozempic, Mounjaro, Zepbound, and the effect of these drugs on reducing weight, controlling diabetes, but very interestingly, reducing inflammation. Yes, there is new research available that reveals that they might have the power to reduce inflammation throughout the body, from your brain to the liver and possibly the joints. Now let's begin.
Rheumatologistoncall.com.
Everyone talks about GLP-1 agonist medication since the FDA approved Mounjaro on November 23, 2023. But did you know that this class of medication called GLP-1 or glucagon-like peptide 1 was actually approved since 2005 for patients with diabetes type 2? How do they work? GLP-1 agonist medication works through a few types of mechanisms. They can decrease the secretion of insulin from your pancreas. They can delay the emptying of your stomach, which can keep you full for a longer period of time. And very important, these medications will reduce your appetite. Why? Because this GLP-1 is also known as the hunger hormone. When you take these drugs, the drug will activate the GLP-1 receptors in your brain, and that will decrease your appetite, making your brain believe that you are full. That's tricky, correct? There are also some studies that suggest that it may even change your taste. So you may start craving for less calorie-dense foods over high-fat, high-sugar foods, and that will also help you lose weight. And it appears that it may boost your metabolism by influencing certain areas in the brain. What does it mean for inflammatory diseases? It means a ton. Now, what is interesting and particularly of great benefit for our patients with autoimmune diseases like rheumatoid arthritis, psoriatic arthritis, and even patients with osteoarthritis is that there is new evidence that these drugs might help or might influence and decrease inflammation throughout the whole body, from the brain to the liver and possibly the joints. Initial studies were published in animals, and now they are starting to appear in humans. One randomized control study that was just published in 2023, it did show that in patients who use these GLP-1 drugs and combine them with exercise resulted in a decrease in inflammatory markers like C-reactive protein, as well as reduced abdominal obesity, which will lead to further benefits and improve in the metabolic syndrome. If you didn't know, abdominal obesity is key in increasing your cardiovascular risk. Another study in patients with rheumatoid arthritis also shown a potential benefit of using these GLP-1 drugs. There is also new evidence that shows that it may decrease inflammation in the brain, and this can help people with Parkinson's disease or Alzheimer's, which are diseases linked to inflammation in the brain. And there are also some small studies that show that these drugs can decrease inflammation in the liver. Now, as I told you before, obesity is linked with more inflammation and increasing the risk to develop arthritis, from osteoarthritis to rheumatoid arthritis, psoriasis, and psoriatic arthritis. People with psoriasis do have more active disease, more joint pain if they have psoriatic arthritis, and they often require higher doses of medication if they are obese. I actually had a patient with psoriasis and psoriatic arthritis where I had to change multiple biologic medications as they were not working. All of them were coming at a fixed dose in a pen, and at some point I realized that I better change this from a pen to an infusion because I can control the dose of this medication based on the weight. And that helped. But again, until this patient was able to lose more weight, he continued to struggle with psoriasis and psoriatic arthritis. there are still many questions that we have at this time. What happens when you stop taking this anti-obesity medication? What are the potential side effects? Are they safe for the long-term use? And could they replace one day steroids and immunosuppressants for inflammation? Only time will tell. We need more research to understand these kind of implications. Although we are excited to see more from these drugs and the use expanded into the field of rheumatology, I think there are a few more years that we have to wait and see if they hold benefit for our autoimmune diseases. Now, be aware that like any drug, there is also a chance for you to develop side effects. And you should know about the fact that these drugs may increase the chance to develop severe nausea, abdominal pain, diarrhea, sometimes acute pancreatitis, which is an inflammation of the pancreas, and rarely they can increase the risk of cancers. If you have psoriasis, rheumatoid arthritis, osteoarthritis, or any other inflammatory condition, please share your thoughts. Have you tried Ozempic, Mounjaro, or Zepbound? What effects did you notice on inflammation and pain levels? Leave me a comment below. If you want to learn more about autoimmune diseases like rheumatoid arthritis, psoriatic arthritis, and many others, and if you want to learn about diet, other lifestyle intervention, and also the new treatments, emerging treatments, subscribe to my channel. I post a new video every week, and they will explore the latest medical research, innovations that could improve your life. Until the next time, stay curious and stay healthy.
Rheumatologistoncall.com